Hey everybody, what's up? Yeah, I know, I've been battle damaged. It did it. Well, actually I did. Ratchet slip. But you wanna know why? Rear shocks. Thing had a case of the bounces. Shocks had what, 120, 140,000 on them? 140. Had 140,000 miles on them. And manufacturer's suggestion is like every 60,000 miles to change them out. And trust me, it was more than due. I've driven this Jeep several times, ridden it countless times. It was due, way overdue. So y'all, hang out with us. Show us we're gonna show you how to change some rear shocks, and we learn from the mistake and don't do it. Let's do it. Okay, everyone, get these back shocks off. First thing we need to do is, here's the shock. Here's the bottom mount. Follow it all the way up, and right there. The beam is hitting directly on it. See right there? That's one of them. It's a 13 millimeter. Other side. Now if you see in my other my front shock absorber video that rear shocks are not as easy. Right there. See the beam directly hitting it? That's the other side, 13 millimeter. And for the bottom side, we got, I think it's 18 millimeter, was it? Yeah. This side's 18 millimeter. That side over there is 15, I'm pretty sure. I don't want to lie to you guys. Let me check, make sure. Yeah, 15. So, 15 millimeter, 18 millimeter, 13 millimeter up top. Take them out. Okay, peeps. There it is. If I can get the light right, there it is. Shocks out, that's what you got left. And of course, right there, you got that shock out. Now, the trick to going back in, reach back behind me. Okay, people, bear with me, the camera craziness here. Notice on the shock right here, the T shape up here, this has a certain tilt to it. Save yourself some headaches and pay attention to that. Because you put it in backwards, like I'm actually intentionally doing now. What you camera's not gonna see is that it's not gonna sit flat against it. So basically what you're doing is you're lining the shock up with the angle of mount here and coming back there. So basically what you're gonna do, you're just gonna pay attention to where that shock sits flat, that mount sits flat, the body up there. Then comes down here, which I know that's all twisted right now, but we'll get to that here in a moment. So first things first, we're gonna hold that shock up there and I'm gonna get the bolt started. But obviously I can't do that and hold the camera, and there's no way to get a tripod up in this mess. So hold the shock up there and get your bolt started.
Good shot.
Yep. People, I had a dumb moment when I explained this a moment ago. Go ahead and get your bolt started on one side. Because you see, let's see if I can do this and lay it in here bolt. I had a total brain fart. That little fork right there, if you get one of your bolts started, you're eating. This one, I'm on the driver's side of the Jeep, the inside one will be the one you want to start by hand to start out with. Then hook this into it, because it's gonna be the harder one to get to. Then the other side, I should be able to get to it with my hand. So I'll tell you what, let me get that bolt started and I kind of show you what I'm talking about. There's the bolt right there, I just got it started. Then you take the shock, bring it up, and just let that slide right inside the bolt right there. That's gonna hold it in place for you pretty much till you can get the other side started. And once you get the other side started, you can turn loose the shock and it won't conk you in the head. So there's how we do it. Okay, we'll get to the bottom in just a moment. Okay, got the other top bolt way up yonder as it started. You can see it right there. My finger out there just. Right there, okay, there's the top bolt. They are not tight. They're just probably about 5 threads in. Because you want it where, pull this loose, you can see, it's just floppy, just kind of hanging out there. That's all it's doing. There's a reason for that. Now down here, here's where your bottom shock mount is gonna go to. Let me see what the camera sees. Oh, there it is. All right, see, it's twisted. It's all wobbly jolly. It ain't gonna work, but that's okay. Because you can turn this, put this in place, and they'll kind of hold itself for the moment. Then what I do with the bolt. Here we go. take your bolt and go ahead and feed through like that. We're good. At this point, we take our wire cutters. I'm in a really weird position, people, and the camera. Ba-ding! We made music. And just cut them off because you don't need them more. You ever cut this one? And be sure to cut them all out before you get your bolts tied, just in case you pinch the wire and you say, dang, I can't get it out no more. There's that one out. There's that one out. Now, peeps, all you gotta do is put your bolts back in, tie them all up. It's pretty simple.
Okay, what are you doing?
Whew, so much fun. Go ahead. Hey, everybody, give you a little pointer. Don't let the ratchet slip. See what happens? That's smarts. Ratchet slip, popping right there in the nose. That's gonna be pretty. Anyway, it's all right. Something that really should point out to you guys. Look, if y'all squeamish for blood out there, I'm sorry, but hey, if we're wrenching on cars, things happen. All right, I'll show you guys something. Sorry about the craziness, but the camera crazy for trying to get you guys a shot. I turned my lens thing around so I can see what I'm seeing. Okay, look, that inside bolt right there is an absolute pain in the butt to get to. It really is. The outside one over here is obviously pretty easy. Here's what you need to do. That shock, it needs to go, let me switch hands with the camera here. Have your bolt still loose, point it that way. Push the shock as far that way as possible. That'll give you room to get your socket inside there. If you don't, the socket's not gonna make it. If you tighten that side up first, you're screwed, because you're not gonna get your socket in here. Push your, again, take the shock, push it away from the frame here. Give your room to get your socket up inside there. Tighten this one down, then your other side over here is just a walk in the park. So I just discovered that because I tightened up the side over here first, and I discovered, dang, I can't get my socket there now. Then I had to loosen it up, push the shock over. So my mistake become your education. All right, everyone, 2,000 mile TJ, Jeep Wrangler TJ. There's changing the back shocks. As you can see, here's a battle. It fall back, but we won, conquered. Hey, part of the nature of just working on cars, sometimes you get a little casualties, which is okay. If y'all squeamish for blood, again, like I told you a minute ago, I'm sorry. So just be sure, like I pointed out, take that shock on the very top mount, push it over, away from the frame as much as possible, help get your socket inside there. Don't cut those little wires until you get in place, because they'll be, is it hard? Yeah. It's not easy by any stretch of the imagination, but it's not exactly the easiest thing either. Use that wire to your advantage to put them in place before you cut them. So if you like my video, thumbs up and comment down below if you got an easier way of doing things, or okay, if you want to make fun of my bloody nose, that's fine too, I don't care. And be sure to subscribe. You gotta subscribe to get these fun videos. I got a lot of cool things coming up, so you really, you know, you should subscribe. One more thing, www.fixjeeps.com. Go check it out. It's where this video and other ones land, and lots of other great information. So go check it out, www.fixjeeps.com. So everyone, if you like my videos, remember thumbs up, rate, subscribe, and yes, those other things. Peace out, everybody. Later.